broadcast live. Cool Cat is in the building. I just signed him in. Tell a friend it's about to go down.
Hey. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. What's good?
You know what I feel like? I feel like, you know that feeling before a show?
Yeah.
The like, butterfly. I don't know if you still get it. Like, yeah, that butterfly is like, damn, what should all I play?
Time.
Like,
all the time. All the time, bro. You know that.
That's
you
what
know,
it feels
you know,
like.
You're not alive if you don't get you're not alive if you don't get that shit.
You're not alive, right?
I'm not alive.
You have to get it. You have to get it. What's good? That's What's good? Are you ready for this?
I'm ready, bro. I'm ready. What you got? Let me see. Actually, can I start it off?
Okay, let's start it off. Let's start it off. Let's just tell the people what's going to be happening. I think this is the rules. I don't know. Gemini and Tweezy, they got to post this on the internet or something, but I think these are the rules. You get to play any track that you featured on, that you produced or wrote, that's your track, whatever. I think it's 14 rounds, and the last round is a bonus track. Maybe it's a new track, unreleased track, whatever it is. So I think that's the rules.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. Mina, I want to take it year by year. I think that's my rule. Can we take it year by year?
Are you trying to go year by year? Okay.
Okay. Year by year, bro.
Okay,
and
let's see.
I'm really feeling like, yo, South Africa has got a lot of haters because in 2014, Ebengi Shisa, bro. I was really hot. I should have gone.
Let them know. Let them know. Yeah, let them know.
This is the first Magangi I got. This is the first one I got. This is the first one. This is like in 2012, though.
Hello. No, Zaba, boy. Zaha, Briaz. Young, it's a shred, that is. Shit, shower, and shave, you know? It's time to misbehave. No, go on, and then. Shut up, my boy.
Aibo. Okay. Acacia.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
We just started TGIF. In Friday, TGIF. Good Friday, TGIF. IF. It's a Friday night shape.
You see what I got? I'm done, bro.
Okay. He took us all the way back.
Yeah.
Okay, if you want to take it back, I think it's only right that we do something like this.
Let's see what you got.
I'm sorry about this one. You're going to have to forgive me, bro.
Hey, yo. I think we should put the turn up on hold. I say, put the turn up on hold. It's the remix. It's your boy DJ Dimples. Bring the rap game back. Bring the rap game back. I got him made up.
Chicks in a mixin', gullin' a puzzle, thick in a vixen, umfagelum photo. I take me magi, please ngenzu lavi, funo gook schema, zuila mapari. Nati okay, love, gena gule transi, wati okay, mugs, jo, amoshis kati, okay, so we move. Wajela bo wa choose, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Girls and hamba nalo dude, bati aye, why you hamba nai? Why ti now shia, natis funo gook schema, ama nigga, wati bai, aye nyo lala nai. Hendu buti ni tini, velang nandaba, lo puti umkaza. She knows how I keep it on in these streets, 100 degrees every time.
We have to take it back there.
I think Max, we need something for Max, bro. Makubani, come on, bro. Max.
That was like, for me, the hottest verses on that joint. Mugs, Uchinja Trill came and did something crazy. Uchinja
Trill, really crazy.
And, Uquesta and Kid X at that time, they were coming with like similar styles. It was almost like they had similar styles. So when they're going back, it was almost like a back to back. By the time you come in, Nadia, oh man, it was crazy, bro. It was crazy.
I wonder, after I heard the back-to-back between, even with Mugs, like Mugs, Kid X, no Quest, I felt like I wouldn't mind like a mixtape with just the three of them on raps, like as a rap
exactly.
group.
Exactly.
It'll be crazy. I think exactly. it's not too late. It's not too late.
Exactly.
It's not
exactly.
too late.
Bro. Exactly.
But check what I got.
Let's go round two.
Check what I got.
Turn it up.
Check what I got.
Turn it up.
Can download this on MP3. Or when you think you live, OMFG. TV, SABC 4. Roof on fire, yeah, we see 4. Nothing like MX9. Something about 325. Bus donors, streets come alive. Township to all work 925. Sasa Benza after 5, you come alive.
I'm sorry about my sound, man. I'm not in my studio. I'm all the way in Durban, so I'm having to do with what I have. This is literally what I have. This is the speaker I have, man.
So nah, it's all good.
If the sound is bad, I'm sorry, guys. But yeah,
now
show must go on.
We got you.
What you got?
What can we put? What can I put next to that one now?
That's how I was still making bass music with London Cats. Crazy stuff.
Yeah. Let me take it like this. Let me take you like this. I'm going to fast forward a little bit, but let me take you around about the same time. And I asked you to be on this joint. You didn't jump on this joint. So I'm going to have to drop it. I'm going to have to drop it just for the summertime. You hear me?
The whole time.
Hey, I'm with the poison, toys, noisin', 100 stacks, oisin', make your honey frozen. So got me, no bother me. Why you mona me? When I'm up, no, all they say is body me. Tell you try, cause we're fine, who might try? Hey, when I hit it, I'm a single.
Aye.
I'm gonna have to turn it up.
I'm just Harlem shaking that one.
I'm gonna turn it up on you. You know what I got next?
What's up?
Hey, this is too much. Let's check. This is for the hood now. Also London Connect now. Shout out to Kid Funk.
Yeah, she's a glamada. Pity Malinga Ganan. Hamba na bangan is pity na banjuan. Banganyan is petu twalum gaganan. Is pity nyamengaganan. Groovanga sekai. Mongbonu bambikan. We broke up in 99. Ish. Ngapalingwa. Umtetwa ku salukan. Gantu salukan. Ilinga tu salukan. Gatu salutan. U salutan.
Remember that thing there?
Usankumbule.
I feel like that thing wasn't pushed like to its full potential. But it's a real crazy one. Even when I perform it till today, people go crazy, man.
Wasn't Teleman on that joint?
No, it was Andy Boy. It was Andy Boy on
it was
the
Andy Boy.
Yeah, it was Andy Boy. They sound similar, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, it was Andy Boy. Like that, that humming.
And Kid Funk.
Kid Funk, Johnny Miller, Cuba, a lot of people on that track. It's dope, man.
I.
What you got, I mean, bro? What you got?
I don't know how I'm going to do it, but I might need to just move the chair for this one.
Be careful. I'm still in 2013, by the way. I'm still in 2014.
Yeah. I'm still way back. I'm still way early. I'm still way early. But I'm gonna fast forward you a little bit. I'm gonna fast forward you a little bit.
All right.
I just moved to an island. Me mug, no smiling.
Hey, I remember that.
But today ballin', I couldn't tell. My honey, they look like Lazelle. I book them into the hotel. They callin' my phone, I switch up myself. Hey, for sec. These bitches are crazy about Kuzek. My niggas are on Agolozek. Hey, fuck up this rap shit. These niggas pretenders. You think I let tender? Visit my lemma. And tell them we tryna get rich for December. Ish, summer, September. I'm chasing this money like I got a tempo. Ish.
I wonder, you're really superling with the flows there. It was too much.
Nah, that was crazy. But shout out to...
Also, Bunle Speed, in terms of like, you want to call out Malema like that on a verse. Bunle Speed, bro.
That shit was crazy.
Check what I got now.
Pop my banner. Snap back, spag and move alike. I'm pop my banner, hit the flow, smart mambala like. Siabangana, hit the scene, riabatan, halalan, siaba ends, massivella, mnati fella, style, sella head, swanky korobe, push swank in foreign lands. A big shout out to Brahmandel, apathetic with Melly Pen, xenophobia Melly Pen, keep it real like 2010, swank tournament, the weekend is black and land, on the streets, as Bambi, Karakara, Caravel. Siabalel, ula decide, snyamalel, shwee, snyamalel, turn up juice, tabalel, promise to feel bad.
I was thinking I could say this, that verse can go on. I think I had like 36 bars. That time, nobody could tell me how many bars I could write in the studio. So I used to just go on, bro. But I really feel like, I was listening to the song, I really feel like people slept on Spook Matambo's verse, bro.
Yeah.
Like JR came through, but Spook Matambo. No way.
They didn't hear him like that. They weren't trying to hear him. You know, it's the same thing that I guess like more you than me, because I was sort of after you introduced yourself, I was sort of coming behind that. But
yeah.
The aesthetic of Spook Matambo always made people feel like, should we listen to this cat or should we not? You know how people are so like.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
But that verse
was crazy. But your verse, crazy. I'm sure you could have gone 48 bars. But that's why they call you the feature killer. That's why it's 90 down or nothing. That song is why it's 90 or nothing.
Yeah, 90K or nothing, bro. I'm not even like all of my friends, if you guys want to hit me up about like, yo, let's do something for free, I'm not doing it for free. I lost too many relationships like that, bro.
Yeah.
Cats came through begging, and then I did them a favor, and then the next thing everybody's saying I killed them on the track, and they don't wanna perform with me. We don't have a relationship.
This nigga says,
but I'm not here for politics. Let's carry on, bro.
Wow. What do we do with that? Okay. Okay, maybe we're gonna have to do it like this. Since we're doing some features, let me come in like this, but let me take you to 2019.
Yeah.
Shout out to Younger.
Look, I got I don't think we have anything for you.
Let's do like this. I fell in love with them bosses. I fell in love with them bosses. I could pull up in pajamas. I could pull up in pajamas. I got to fill the garage. 9-11 look like Red and Mondage. Baby mama look like Nicki Minaj. Little Mikey look like me, oh my gosh. Money looking like it's heavenly sent. I pray for every cent. I think I gotta repent. I murder every event. I'm trying to prevent death, but it's looking so damn imminent. There's no argument, I am 100% the reason why hip-hop is drenched. Drip drip, drip drip, drip drip. Nangu da dog, nangu da dog. Panda my coins, minu ar.
Rest in peace, Abokanabo, please.
Yo.
You got me fighting. After that, bought my band, and now I have to fight.
Yeah, you have to. But I'm still in 2015, by the way, bro.
Let's go. Okay.
And
okay.
That's why
we're
like,
going round five now. We're going round five.
In 2014, 2015, man, Shisaka cool. It's crazy. I've got one award from South African hip hop for the 100K mixtape. But I feel like I should have gotten more awards, man.
Let them know.
I don't know more in South Africa, but it's neck.
Check this out. None, man, you're on five, but...
I'm sorry, but I had to do this.
Since I'm Swenko, aka Future Mfana,
I'm rolling with Buzz and Bafana. We be keeping it fresh in it. I'm hungry like Tony Montana, Manolo. Before the rebanger hit, we really the best in it. Best, you fucking impressed in it. Impressed, we really up next in it. Next, you looking at excellence. My life is a movie, it's steady. And it's dangerous, but it's daedalic. My tongue is a Uzi, I'm blasting it. The cherry and Funa, I'm smashing it. She showed me a booty, I'm smacking it. Shade too puffin', I'm passing it. I'm passing it. My game is on excellence. I come with the flexi plan. Jump in my taxi then. Relaxing it.
Oh my gosh.
Hitty. Ay, 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 gag. And gag, ay. Up on my charge. I call on my charge, Glele, in the life.
I will come at charge. What's the charge after?
I'm sure you look at my charge.
Okay, round five, no, ne?
Yeah, in the competition there, I'm a judge to tell you what I see a boom at some point. It's only celebrate at some point. You know what I mean? I bet. I'm a judge.
I'm swank. I'm swank. Okay, Lale, like. Okay, yeah. Lale. I get so, shall I my anthem, man?
Yeah.
Shall I my anthem, man?
Yeah, pen.
Just pull up my anthem.
Pen.
Okay, I'll test it.
That's it. No album cuts.
Okay, I'll test it. I'm going to end them, I need.
Pen, bro. Pen.
Okay. Lale Lang, the first.
Oh, you just bought a Benz, nigga, fuck that shit. Oh, you bought this to club, pop out of your so-called friends, nigga, fuck that shit. Oh, you say you got chains, let me see them shits. Motherfucker, them links ain't...
Awena.
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 But it's crazy. It's crazy. You know, like, with that one, like, yeah. There was a time when... We were just recording, I think, at Ganja Beats studio, and we're doing the Boys in Box mixtape.
Yeah.
What made me do that song to say Fuck Yellow Nyes was I got arrested leaving Ganja Beats studio and going back home. I got arrested.
What?
So,
what happened?
I didn't want to tell the story.
I don't remember that one.
So I got arrested in the whip. I was driving. I wasn't meant to be driving, but I was driving, right?
Yeah.
When I came back, I was like, Ganja, give me the hardest beat you have. The only thing I want to say on this song is Fuck Yellow Nyes. and the crazy part is that we asked Wally and them for permission to say fuck Lil Nas, and they were like, cool, which was dope. It really means everything came together. It's crazy.
Yeah, man. And it's like, and I think that's a very big lesson for a lot of people trying to make music. It's like the stuff that really works is the stuff that's emotionally charged. You know what I mean? Like if you're really feeling it from the heart and you go in a booth, it's definitely gonna catch with people. People are gonna, if it was just conceptual, it wasn't gonna be as big as the song became, I think. You know what I mean?
So
I think that's one big lesson that like kids can get from that. Cause I really feel the same with like a lot of songs that like Umswanko, all of that stuff there, where we like really shouting out like, yo, you have to recognize that we pushing Umswanko, not you guys. Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so
it was a clear message, very clear message.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
It's like if you're online and you do a post, if it's like emotionally charged, it's going to catch on then more than if you're just fucking around. You understand what I'm saying? Like, if you're really feeling, yo, I want to put this caption out, a lot more people are going to catch it because it's coming from you. And that's just a spiritual thing. A lot of people don't get that. It's a really spiritual thing, you know?
It's a real thing.
Yeah, man. But you know what I got? You know what I got next, bro? I don't think you're ready for this thing now.
This is round six.
Actually, I wanted to play Slizer, but I think I'll give it to you. It's fine. It's fine. So let's go. We're still in 2015 now. I'm going. Okay.
Cassette, 100k my cassette. Lazy Milano party straight na my pack. Sipping on champagne, sweet demisec. Your weekend is in the swank na my cell. Nanga bella school is nice, John my fell. Dabba na my kick, sassy fresh, no my cack. Petu my cassette, but to swank dog or dead. Mangi bella, but to swank or a bed. Senoritas like Guantara Mera. Uya pandu push push panamera. Slash la madende, oh panamera. Jump on my fence and you shincha, oh bend. Then the Esha welling gets sweet and I go bend. We have this body every day, see I enter. Dude, that was slender. Zulu Michael Jackson. Dancing a flexer. Nah, yeah, Slizer. Never see me biser. Stepped like a tiger. Swanking in a biker. Roaming like a shy guy. Added to the Naya. Smoking with
bad guy. I was a bad guy. 2014, 2015, man.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Yo, too much.
Okay.
I don't know. That track is like, I don't think it'll ever die. Like, I'm really, that track right now for me, I'm really, like, I might be taking it out of proportion, but I put it up there with Sister Bettina in terms of when it dropped, everyone just goes,
straight away.
I'm from the hood. You know what I mean? Like,
straight away.
It's really crazy, man. It's really crazy.
Straight
Shout
away.
Out to Ndu one time. Shout out to Ndu, yo.
Yo.
What you got, bro?
Oof. Okay, so I'm gonna have to come with a strategy on that one. Come with a strategy. Now this one is called strategy now. Yabon?
What you got, bro?
Yabon? I think it's a strategy, man. Just Sam. It's gotta be right. It's gotta be right. It's gotta be right.
I really
feel like you don't sing enough, bro. You should do a lot more singing, bro.
I love the singing, but it's just so hard to do it live. Like when I write joints where I sing, it's so hard to do it live, like, because it's always like, it's hard, man. By the time I get to those joints, I can't even sing. I can't even sing.
I see.
So it's like, but I really want to do more. Like, I'll be always begging, like, these guys, like, to send me these, not even R&B, but, like, songs to sing. Like, even writers to write me songs to sing. Because I enjoyed it.
Yeah, man. I'm sorry. I gotta hit you with this thing next, bro.
Which one, boy?
It's too much. I'm just gonna start here.
Come on, I'm not telling. Smile. Nice to meet you. I'm gonna go
there. I'm going to
go there.
Okay, and it's important why you started a day. It's very important why you started a day.
I can squeeze
where
you.
Yeah, exactly. It's very important.
Okay, cool.
Exactly. Okay, all right. So.
No, me go, me no.
Oh, hey, Dobe,
I'm sorry, I gotta plug this, but I really feel like people need to check out the short film. I'm a lobo, the short film. We really worked hard on that. There was no brand involved. Everything was literally for my money from shows. I actually financed the whole thing, produced the whole thing. Shout out to Lenzo, shout out to Sunnet, shout out to everybody who was involved. Like, yo, man, I don't understand how we're not sitting on 1 million views on that film, but it's here's the song. It's gotta be.
I feel you now.
Yeah,
I feel you.
Yeah,
very
man,
important, very key. But,
yeah, it's like, and I think if we can focus on those little things, because it's not just me that made a short film. There's a lot of other artists that actually do all these other little things on the side, but people are always just like, yeah, drop music. I'm like, yo, I just dropped a t-shirt last week. That's also a hit. You understand what I'm saying? No, drop music. Yo, we just did this last week. Like, everything we put out,
everything,
I think, is important.
Yeah, try consume everything and not just consume, but try follow the intention of the artist when he puts out something. You know, it's very important.
Exactly.
Like, because even we also did a short movie, the Exodus short movie that we did also. I think it's like people have such a low attention span. So that was like 15 minutes. I think yours was like 12 minutes. It was like 12, 10 minutes.
It's around, let me just check, 14.
About 14 minutes, yeah, same.
Yeah,
so same time.
14, yes.
It's that attention span. So we got to keep doing that and keep teaching them.
Yeah.
Shout out to Sunil.
Yeah, man. Yo,
shout out to Sanelle, shout out to Linza.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Princess. Shout out to everybody. Shout out to Mahou. Shout out to everybody involved there, man. Yo, let's get back. Let's back into it.
So it's round six. I know you tried to slow us down a little bit, but I'm going to have to... I can't slow it down. I got to keep it going fast. Let me do it like this.
Whoa, we
Hey, Dumi, you better give me that verse of the year. You owe me for this one. Stogie T owes me verse of the year for this one. I'm gonna start campaigning.
We want the whole. We want the whole thing. Whole thing. We want the whole thing. Whole thing. We want the whole thing. Whole thing. We want the whole thing.
Okay, now go buzz on. Let's do it like this.
We want.
I put the structure for these niggas. They taking me lightly. Mama told me some would love me and some would dislike me. Motherfuckers want me dead, but the money revived me. Most likely I'm alive, they can never be like me.
Hey,
everyone, Lalela, Stogie T. Don't make me record more of those. Put me inside the verse of the year. I'm mine.
what is that verse of the year? What is that?
I don't know, but it's dope, man. It's like, I think they put together all the verses. Like all music, it's not just like commercial music, it's underground, commercial, everything. They put it together and they analyze the verses. So you actually discover, like, because you know, usually like guys like that, are, I guess, like that are like commercial, that in the limelight, always think they have the best verses. So they're actually going down to dig other verses, not just like big songs. They also go into like, so it's a really dope thing that they're doing. They're really dope shit that they're doing.
I've seen so many lists about like, yo, who's like the best rapper, like the verse, the best verses, Banban. And it's crazy. I've never been in any list. Not that I'm trying to be, but I've never been. And I think, I just sit back and I think to myself, like the crowd is going, you got the best verse. But whoever say the verse of the year, they don't include me. Is it because maybe they don't understand and everybody in South Africa understands me? But they don't,
play something. Play something. Show more.
It's crazy. Let's go. We're gonna take you down Gomway Street. I really
feel like that track a lot of people categorize it under Gom, but it's Gom Wave. So Gom Wave is basically raps on Gom beats. And I think a lot of cats, as much as a lot of cats don't want to admit, a lot of cats started making Gom after that track because they were like, yo, and it's silently wave. Everyone was like, no.
They came in fast. It's actually kind of sad, like, not sad, but why do you think Gom sort of went like this and then like quickly fizzled? Because I think it was like two seasons, two seasons.
I think from where I'm sitting, obviously these are not facts, this is just my opinion, but where I'm sitting, it gone by the time they got it, it was a bit old in terms of like lighter, but it hadn't grown as a genre in terms of like till today. You haven't heard like a deep vocal gom track. You haven't heard a gom track with like maybe a saxophone, like a jazzy gom track, just like how you hear deep house or deep vocal house. And so as a genre, it wasn't as grown as Amapiano is per se, you understand? Because Amapiano, I can come through and rap on it. Someone else can come through and sing. Someone else can come and do like Ashama jokes. Someone else can actually just Ashama jokes throughout an Amapiano track and it'll work.
Yeah.
But Gom wasn't as, you know, as diverse at the time that it grew
up. At the time.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, like, when I listen to what Shoma Josie is still doing, Shoma Josie still, she doesn't give a damn, like, is the beats, are people saying this is still the popular sound or whatever? She's still riding the wave because she loves the sound.
That's the thing.
You feel the same, like, this is like one of the sounds I love. I'm still gonna make music to it.
Like on my album, I've got like about like 3 gom tracks. You understand? And I had more. And it's just like it's like, cause like what I was saying, it's gom, what we're doing, like what me, Shoma Josie, and other people that are rapping on gom, that's gom wave. That's like different to the other like ways, just speeds. You understand what I'm saying? So
yeah.
So, and we're still waiting for somebody else to come through and just like sing a nice, you know, like how you'd hear like a deep vocal house track. There's gonna be stuff like that. But it's just, it's South Africa, Satan is it, you know what I mean? Like, it's South Africa, when back on about Hamba and the Hamba. But I think after a lockdown, because right now people are chilling at home and people, in terms of, actually, Mina, this is what I like. Whereas before, everyone has listened to Amapiano. But I think by the time we get back from the lockdown, everyone would know what they like and they're going to subscribe to what they like. Whereas right now, everyone just subscribes to what's trendy.
Because
there's no ways we dance the same and we like the same music. There's no ways. I don't believe it.
Facts. Malumkoolkat.
Aware. What you got?
Since you're talking about game changers, let me put a game changer next to it also, ne? If you don't mind.
Okay, sharp. Let's go.
But I'm going back now. I'm going back to 2015. I guess you said you were going that way. I'm going back that way. Let's go. Let me explain to everybody. Let me tell the story. Everybody shut the fuck up. Let me tell a story. Everybody keep quiet. Let me tell a story. So that one, because Dimples, there was a story with Dimples speaking about that track. So
yeah.
Everyone is saying, explain the Dimples story. Hey, listen, I can't dispute what Dimples was talking about in the story that he told about that track when he played that in his battle with Speedster.
Yeah.
Right? From what I remember from this song, right?
Yeah.
Every time, it wasn't the first time we had used the phrase pop my bottle la pop champagne.
Yeah, exactly.
You know that, right?
Yeah.
We were saying that we were saying that for like 4 years before that.
Yeah, dropped, I did right? So many songs, like even Usanel has got verses. Yeah, we've been on
hundreds.
Yeah.
So that was actually slang. Pop my bottle was actually a slang to say we're going to pop bottles. Pop bottles. So I'm not disputing Dimples' story. This is for everybody out there who wants to know the Dimples story. I'm not disputing the story.
What did he say with Dimples?
Dimples was saying that I don't know his reasoning for playing the song in his thing, but I gave him the go-ahead to play the song in his battle against Speedster. From what I remember, and maybe Dimples didn't get to explain it further. From what I remember, you know that feeling? Well, I get that feeling sometimes when I make a hot track and it doesn't fit on an album.
Yeah, so, that happens.
So I was done with my album, Family Values, and I just made Bozonke, right?
Yeah.
And Upozonke didn't fit in with the rest of Family Values as a project.
Mm.
So at that time, I was calling people for the record, to either take the record or do something with it. And I clearly remember...
You should have given it to me. You should have given it to me, bro.
I should have given it to you, but I needed it so I can win this battle tonight.
Exactly.
Yeah. So I can do this round, so I can survive this round. But so...
Yeah, bro.
So from what I remember... I remember being in studio with Dimples, not to write the song or to make the song. The song was done. But
yeah.
The people that really contributed the most to that song was Usanele, the guy from Boys and Bucks.
Yeah.
Who had a verse for that song who didn't end up on the record.
Hey, you should have kept his verse there. Bro.
That's one of my biggest regrets. I should have kept his verse on that record. But Sanele, the girl, Kitty, the girl.
Yeah.
Kitty, the director.
Yeah.
They did the...
Yeah.
They sang. So I sang the hook and I asked them to re-sing the hook. And I even might have remembered me mixing and mastering the song with Miss Cosmo in the studio. Miss Cosmo needs to say if she remembers that. I remember trying to decide what to do with the record with also Miss Cosmo in the studio. So it's not like Dimples was capping or doing whatever. But...
Yeah.
I think at the time, I didn't want to put out the record. So I think I was shopping it around, but it ended up to the point of like, I'm just going to put it out myself, basically. But it wasn't a thing of, it wasn't, and Dimples wanted to put it out. It's not like he didn't want to, but I think it was a case of, let me put it out. This song is going to change my life. And, and it actually changed my life. Because before that, it was like, Amantombazane and Afuka and all that. It was very like, how do I say it was like still very underground, but when Bozonka came out, that's really what made Riky Rick. Until this day, they still call me Bozonka because of that record. So it's like it's actually crazy. So Dimples is not capping, but I'm letting you know that there's something like that in the story, something like that. But Dimples wasn't capping. It could have been a song. Sorry about that. It wasn't. It was mine.
Away. Check, yes, in beginning to call it, but I'm gonna hit you with like one of my favorites from I did like a two EP deal with this record label in Austria.
Holy motherfucking oxygen.
Let me look for it quick. Let me look for it. Where's holy oxygen, bro? Holy oxygen. No ways, bro. I almost played it juicy, but I was like, guy, holy oxygen, no ways, bro. No ways, guys. No ways. And you know what's crazy about holy oxygen is it's super quarantine, super social distancing. Like, check that.
Holy oxygen. It's so, bitch, I'm bad. Holy oxygen. Yo, Sanbonani, Inkosi Benani, Umalumkoolkat and his brother Aragami.
Holy
negative energy, Sugatuze Wami. Holy Swami, this is the second coming. Tati Zintozami, Umalumkoolkat, True Kati. I'm MJ Foxen, back to the future, and I'm chilling in a front seat.
Yeah, I think a lot of people never used to understand when I was talking about like Future Mfana as a character. So on Holy Oxygen, I'm Future Mfana, like this guy who's basically in 2040. And as you can see, we're in 2020 and we're already kind of seeing glimpses of what I was showing on the video here. I'd like to shout out to everybody that worked on that video. And a lot of people actually asked me, hey, what about what happened about you? Like, you know, like the guy that's riding a horse, the guy that's like, all those guys, like the dogs.
Those are real people.
Those are real people. That's their life, bro.
Those were real people.
Like that guy riding a horse, that's what he does. He's just riding a horse. It's all these guys that we found right next to a dump. It's like, you know, the squatter camps around the dump.
Yeah,
it was crazy, bro. Like that was, I'm glad actually I was working with people that actually had that kind of mindset. Like, cause I had the vision, but they took it to the next level.
To another level.
Yeah, next level, bro.
Hi.
I don't know, hi. bro. I,
I'm going in. Now I'm going deep. I'm going deeper into Mlazi Milano now. I'm sorry.
I know you're going deeper. Eish. But I have to come to
Shambok now.
I think it's the last round before they cut us off, so we're gonna make this one short and then come back to it. Let's do it this. Yes. When they talk about energy. Yeah. There's different ways that energy can come out, né?
Yeah.
There's different ways that it can come out. This one right here, you can't stop the energy. You can never stop the energy. It's impossible. It's impossible. And shout out to the whole team. It was beautiful music that we made together. This one's a classic for life. Let's go. Trust me. Hold on. I didn't even play this shit right. Fuck that.
I didn't play this shit right.
Let's go.
Braga. I just got a key from the Plaga. My niggas is Real Madrid. You niggas is more like Malaga. We spilling champagne like it's lager. The honey you wanted, I got her. I hit it, then don't even call her. She only wanna eat wallet. Her name is whatchamacallit. She call you whatchamahoo. You talking that I wanna wife you. She called that hella baloo. These bitches is fucking for 10 G's. She lucky she got it, I'm stingy. But she remind me of Tandy. I told her to jump on my sandy.
Before we shut off, I wanna let everybody know. When I say these bitches is fucking for 10 G's, I'm not talking from personal experience. We're cutting this off. We're gonna come back again. I'm not talking from personal experience. Scoop. I'm not talking from personal experience. It's got to be more than 10 G's. If it was 10 G's, I'd be disappointed. Hey, we're going to lock back in. We're going to come back in the second round. Everybody tune in. We're about to go to round 11. Let's go.
For now, we're going to do it like this. Yeah.
Mlazi Milano.
What's up, Mlazi Milano?
Yeah, I'm back in the game, but it's second half. Mlazi Milano.
Shay.
We're fucking through passing and back in the team. Was it done?
Intwana yam,
kule
rap hulu man, wanenkinga phaka man, ukwazi ukurap ukhuluma, ukwazi ukuswenga undlulaba, kutshampani ngolobani, dabe ndololwane, sase shobi ngoloba, hayi bo, khandi boxe nganekwana ma, ichupu ngeke kade negula,
spoba gangula, send his spoba over senilis, siyabangena by satellites, pockets getting fed his cellulite, but I'm on a top of steady head, I'm something special like a 38, orange and red, I regulate.
You know, the more I listen to the verses and the music, I think it makes sense why we don't make the list, because the slang, who's gonna explain the slang? And the double and the triple entendres and all the deep stuff is going on in the verses. Like, if none of us are on that table, these guys won't get it.
Nah, they won't.
It's as simple as that. And I think it actually got me to a point where I'm like, actually, yeah, in the future, I think we should be looking at making our own award shows, making, like, you know, stuff like that, where it's like create the infrastructure for ourselves, because even though we're in the game, we're never gonna get recognized the way, you know. Like right now, we're talking all of this stuff, but you know, we there's been a lot of years where, if you go down, like you going down all your hits now, you deserve like at least Ama Award Nyana for some of that stuff. I really feel like the stuff I'm doing, I deserve. You know what I mean? But it's never gonna happen unless I do it myself.
And what you say there, the last one, is actually the point. I mean, when we were coming, there was nobody else who was doing what we were doing, right?
Exactly.
It was completely different, right? So now, with this lockdown and all this corona stuff going on, where everything has basically been burnt to the ground, most things that we thought that was going to be there forever is burnt to the ground. Now the next generation, the new people that are going to come up, they're going to need to create new platforms with new energy. Exactly. And not to say the old ones are going to disappear, but now, like, the kids can get together. Vinny, Zeus, y'all get together and do your own awards. Yeah. You don't need to really put, like, the new wave into the category of the other old niggas who have been doing it.
Who's judging?
Now they can create their own platforms and run with it, because it's like there's no more. How do I say it? There's no more clout. There's no OG of the game now. Like, everyone, it's about fresh ideas right now. So, I think for us, I wouldn't say me, because, like, for me, it's like somehow I became commercial, which is an amazing thing and it's a blessing, you know.
Yeah.
I thank God for that, because, like, you remember, I was trying to be more of a, like, I wasn't trying to be, like, a mainstream SA cat with the music. Yeah. I always wanted to do something else. I just ended up this way.
Yeah,
but,
I see.
But the new guys that can come through, they can stick to their guns. And if they're seeing you doing what you're doing, like, you took us to Hold Oxygen. You've just taken us to La Liga. Now I'm Lazy Milano. And whatever you're going to do next with the next project, that's going to set a whole nother wave. These records that we're playing here set waves. These aren't just records. The records that change shit. You know what I'm saying? Change the way people do things. Exactly. You feel me? Yeah. And I think that's more important than that's more important than any award. You feel me?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Carry on. I think I lost my train of thought there.
Oh, you lost it? No, I got nothing to say. I got nothing to say. Cool. But
so
when round 10. That was round 10. That was round 10.
Play me a song, bro. Yeah.
That was round 10. Let me play a song. But before I play a song, I just need everybody in the comments. I see you out there. We've got 7,000 people in the building right about now. Wow. Can everybody just answer this question? Which way? Which way? Which way? Which way? Gemini, leave those hands. Show me which way. Point which way. I need somebody to point which way. Which way? Which way? Which way? Which way? Which way? Which way? That way.
Hey,
I walk in the Gucci, I bad out. Walk in the Louis, I bad out. All of my niggas is wild now. All of my niggas is wild now. I walk in the Gucci, I bad out. Walk in the Prada, I bad out. All of my niggas is wild now. All of my niggas is wild now. I walk in the Gucci, I bad out. Walk in the Louis, I bad out. All of my niggas is wild now. All of my niggas is wild now. I walk in the Gucci, I bad out. Walk in the Prada, I bad out. All of my niggas is wild now. All of my niggas is wild now.
Hey,
I've seen the live shows when you performed that one. It was too much, bro.
That's like, you know, like that song is like a testament of, like, dog, you don't need a fucking record on radio. It's nice to have a record on radio, but you make most of your dough going out to perform to people.
Exactly. You
make for most people, you make all of your dough going to perform for people. So what you do for the live show, that's really the most important part. So that
the performance art.
It's performance art. So everybody has an opportunity when it comes to a live show. You might not get the opportunity to play on radio. You might not get the opportunity to get crazy streams on Apple or Spotify or whatever people are using. But when you have a live show, whether you're playing at 1 o'clock, or whether you're playing at 5 in the evening, or 4 in the morning, whatever time you have on a live show, you can convince people what they need to do to your art. You feel me?
Yeah, exactly.
And
yeah.
And I get so frustrated, bro. Like, I'm 33 years old, bro. It's like, I can't keep coming up with shit to do for live shows to get people excited. I gotta see, like, I need them to take over. I need, like, yo, Champagne 69 and them, they fucking killing it with the energy. Based on pure energy. Records, like, they don't get crazy records spinning on the radio, except maybe Smoke. But pure energy, they're coming out. This Cost the Kid, it's not just because the records are dope. It's because the energy that he puts into the live performance. You one of those people too, because you don't care whether people know the song or not. You play it and you perform it. And you rock it. It's beautiful.
Yeah, man. It's like, it just, the whole thing with Coca-Cola is still advertising. Like, who do I think I am? Is still like, oh, there's a new tech shop in the hood. Please put it on our brand. They're still advertising. So I'm always going to advertise, like, the songs that are out. And I won't lie, like, in the past maybe 3 years, 4 years, Umuntu has started, like, performing more the commercial stuff instead of everything. But definitely, I feel like a lot of artists need to take note of that. Like, the performance arts is like, a big chunk of how you communicate the music. You understand what I'm saying? And I think just, I'm gonna put this one out for free. Like, because I know we're going to, after this lockdown, everything has to change. I feel like in South Africa, we're lacking shows for into young kids. And a lot of my friends, like 40% or 50% of my friends are like the 10-year-old, the 6-year-old, and they only see me on TV. And if I'm in their hood, they're going to be like, it's going to be like, oh, Shampe, okay, Okmalumkoolkat is coming through, Wamax or Wamjayati. Mm. This kid from Mlazi is like, yo, he's going crazy and he can't wait to start.
He can't wait,
like the South African youth, they can't wait to start smoking and drinking and being at those places. You know, you understand? Instead of having events literally just for them, where you're not gonna get booze, it's just gonna be an afternoon gig. It's an all ages gig. Abu Kutwala, there's like soldiers, there's like slash machines. So I perform, I would go. I think we need a lot more of that because I've been to hoods where we're playing a show and I see like 8-year-olds, and they're drinking. And it's just like, there's nothing right about that. I think we all have to be like thinking like that in the future, you know?
That's the next plan. That's the next plan.
Yeah, that's the next plan.
Cater for Intuana.
But yeah, we have to cater for Intuana, bro. And then also, when you cater for Intuana, it means there can be Ugogo also to come see you. Because not Gogo now, he has to see us. Do you get what I'm saying?
Ugo, hey, listen, I've performed for Abo Gogo, dog. Hey, it's even wilder than our gigs, bro.
I used to perform for Okoko when it was the Red Bull Corner to Corner. That was the craze. I feel like every artist has to go through the Red Bull Corner to Corner because you basically just set up in a street corner and anyone can stop. So Okoko is there. And when you say, everybody say poison bugs, Okoko's like, poison bugs.
Let's get into it, baby.
Have you ever seen a rapper with an apple in his hand? You guys gotta come.
If you think you're fresh death, I'm a steady Caesar. Boys and bucks, we always getting mixed up. Wherever that these chicks are, we always gonna fish.
sipping on that mixture, sipping on a teacup. I'm laying with your sister, she pretty as a picture. I call her Mona Lisa, she's chilling in my t-shirt. My lips are where her lips are, and it's pyramids of Giza. And I lick her, and I sex her. I'm a fixer, so I fixed her. Then I kissed her, released her. Told her I'm a taxer, only when I need her. Now I'm leaning like the Tower of Pisa. Cats wanna catch up, but I give a shit. FYI.
Woo! Oh no, it looks like Kulkat's signal's dying out on my side. I don't know if you guys feel the same. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know what happened. Let's get everybody back in. Okay, we're going to cut the talking to a minimal now. We're just going to finish it up. I said that we didn't want to take it too long, but now it's like crazy long. So let's that live did not save, man. That live did not save, man. That live did not save, unfortunately. That live did not save, bro. I hope somebody screen grabbed it or somebody got it on their side. But that live did not save. Let's get it back up. Let's get it back up. We just started round 12. Malumkoolkat is back. I think the signal cut off. No, it's all good. I think the signal cut off. But what we're going to try to do now is I think let's speed it up a bit and let's finish it off. Because me and you, I know we can, me and you, we can go forever.
I think we should have a podcast, bro.
I think we should. Maybe we should do that. That would help.
We should.
But, okay, let me just see. I'm trying to charge. Oh, man, this is crazy. Now okay, let me see this. Now the mouse is about to die. What's going on here, dog? Now my mouse is about to die, bro.
But no more.
Hold up. We're not there yet.
But no more.
Sorry about this. Let me just connect my mouse real quick. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Malumkoolkat just played Kusheshe. Huge tune. Massive tune. Game changer. But I'm not giving up any rounds. We're doing this for the love of music. We're not giving up any rounds. So we're almost at the end. We might as well do something like this. Let me just switch it up for you, boys. I'm going to switch it up for you a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Let's go.
Uncle Raph just needs to get into the chat. You know what I'm saying? Uncle Raph needs to get into the chat for this one.
I'm just going to take off my hoodie because I'm feeling hot.
Yeah, take it off. Pause. Okay. We're going to make this quick. We're not going to eat any more of the time up. We're going to make this real quick. I'm going toe to toe with that one. I'm not going to give up any rounds. I gave up one round before. I'm not giving up this round.
Let's go. Who's taking score?
I don't know. I'm not even counting score. We're just going right now.
Yeah, we're going, bro. We're going.
Let's go for this one. Round 11, I think. Or 12. Oh, shit. I don't know. But let's go.
This is cocaine.
Sit you cut in.
I ghost.
Do you know any? Is there any other two niggas that put fashion like in the front line of this music shit? Is there? If like, I mean, Uteles did his thing. heavy. Deleuze was like the first, like the one that was like hip hop must be fresh.
Definitely, definitely. Hip-hop fresh must be shout fresh. Out to my homie. Shout out to and then, one time.
But after the second round, when we came through, I don't think even today, cats are still struggling to catch up in terms of the steez.
Nah, it's too much, tough.
It's and tough.
It's crazy because now I'm more of a producer. I'm less of a consumer now. And in fact, actually, I left most of the drip in Joburg, bro. I don't have anything right now. That's why I'm rocking the cooking team, Magangi. You know what I mean? But actually, check what I have here, bro.
Sick driver, me and I'm just Sally move. I'm the shit. Step into the scenic Sally boom. Order of success. Yazing petting bash and good. Shy style, I call it candy, funny boom. We yazing tapas aganjan. Caught in the bagaban. Understand what's up, Bangad. In King and Pedro Satan. He got the Oxupe London. Manja Umkanda Ganjan. He got the Libendela one. Mshana, I'm telling your past. Ahead of the game, couples it done. All over the world, but cover Milan. Lazio Milano, fun on a jet. Pound on the cash, bump on the cash. Top on the cat, selling it fresh. Top on the bottles, bag on the dash. Ratchet traps, on the moves. How am I? Top on the ass. Fuck on my lane, fuck with the best. Talking for Daniel, we get it for next. You wanna relax, stopping with next. On the leg and jam, come as you buy. Killing the game, what the fuck have I done? Been raising my son, I haven't begun. Killing the scene, my mind is a gun.
Ah, that track was too much, bro.
Classic material.
And just to clarify on the Msenko game, just to clarify, like a lot of people are always like, yo, who's the best dressed Banban? Me and Everfaith, I'm gonna come out and say, like, I don't have like the most expensive wardrobe. I just wear stuff that really fits me well. And I'm always on the next when it comes to brands. I always know brands before people know them. And I'm lucky to get like a couple items of those brands that it puts me in a place where it's like, yo, I wonder what else he's got. But maybe I just got that one t-shirt. So I just, you know, and I think people like that. It's like there is, I feel like in South Africa, there is no best dressed. People have their own style now, you know what I mean? Like, Ricky's wardrobe, one day I'm going to go to Ricky's house. I think, yeah. I want to get some stuff from his wardrobe. He's got a bunch of stuff. So that's all I have to say about that.
I always tell people that for me, it's not even about the wardrobe. It's just that I'm a pretty nigga, dog. Like, I'm a really pretty nigga. Like,
they don't get it.
It's like I could wear a plain t-shirt from Woolworths and make it look good. I'm just a pretty nigga.
Same thing, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes you just gotta just do you.
Exactly. A lot of guys don't get that.
Malooms, man. Let me hit you with this one, man. Let me hit you with this one.
What you got?
This one is what for the got? Underground motherfuckers. That was a big tune. This one is for the underground cats. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Let's go.
When I get done, I'ma hit you up. When I get paid, I'ma hit you up. When I get rich, I'ma lift you up. Right now I'm struggling for moolah. I get that Lambo, I'll pick you up. When I get that Lambo, I'll pick you up. When I get that Lambo, I'll pick you up. Right now I'm struggling for money, nigga.
I'm not gonna cut this one, excuse me. I'm gonna keep this one going. We're gonna hear from the boy himself. The boy himself's coming up. I'm gonna give you eight bars. Let's go! When lockdown is over, we're doing Reese Effect. Let's go!
Man, fuck what's out now. It's just hot now, cause I ain't dropped yet. What's coming next is really something else. Name dropping on me for a little recognition, but it didn't really help. Tour started and I'm here, hunted by promoters, you ain't even getting mail. Funny thing about this whole shit, making paradise was a living hell. I don't even have a clue about how the album did, but I know I'm doing.
Yo, I go around now, bro.
What the fuck? Hey, what do you think about A Reese, man? What do you think about A Reese, man, and how he's doing the whole thing, man?
Untwempua cool A Reese. Actually, we're supposed to actually work on a track. I don't know, I'm still waiting on him. I think he teased something. Because almost every day, like one of his fans are gonna hit me up, like, yo, what's up with that track with A Reese? I'm like, I'm waiting on him. So A Reese, if you're listening, hit me up, bro.
Man, right y'all now. Gotta do it. I mean, those guys, I mean, just the whole team that's around him, but Reese himself and Mash, those motherfuckers is like, they're good guys, thorough guys, man. Thorough guys. They focus on what they're doing. It's crazy. And like, I got so much love for those boys. It's like, you know, the more that they actually do the things their own way, it changes the fucking game, man. Changes the game. Exactly. They don't give a fuck who thinks what. They just keep going. So let's drop a bomb for Avery. Drop a bomb for Malumkoolkat.
I think since you went underground, bro, I'm gonna go real underground. I'm just doing this one for my fans. You know what I mean?
Let's go.
Cat with the goodies, yo, I spray like you Uzi and I shoot it like you movie. It can't tell him yeah, yo, I shoot it like you movie. Ichusi, le magic that the fast, shintu one, impelu two. Any MC opega na namu tululu two. Mamambi Mike, nkulu nkulu pumulu su. Ayi ngova gui sabatu guti kusugu misku. So pendugis pugo push. Kansas traffic like Sandy and Katrina. Yeah, I'm fucking up the rigdom. Kansas to your speakers. Starting ya sabisa. Ganting zoba shisa. Tryna count my sneakers, burn it to you either. Vapela, conundrum to your teachers. Of future I'm finding king.
Yeah, I don't think anyone can win with that one. It's just it's too crazy. Much. Quite then, I get goosebumps listening to those raps like, yo, that's future I'm finding. I need to do something as future I'm finding again. Cause I put myself in a space where it's like, yo, it's not you. Forget everything you know and just be in the future. Like, I'm having a phone call with Reika Wakubo. A lot of people don't know who Reika Wakubo is, but she's the lady behind Comdiga Song. I'm talking 2020, a space odyssey, Stanley Kubrick. Like, the references are just like crazy, man. Yeah. I don't know. So whoever is judging these lists, I don't know, man. I'm still on you guys. I don't know. No one can win. I don't understand.
Malums.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to bring you back into 2019.
Let's go.
Because if we're talking about verses,
mm-hmm.
I have to play this one.
Okay, do me a favor. But the hip hop you feel. But I'm on. Man, oh man.
Yeah.
Vulana mesh.
Yeah.
We never die. We multiply, motherfucker.
Uma mankuza ngabangan. Bengi kabangan. Perizeli span. Push up, press up, pan. Uma mankuza ngabangan. Bengi kabangan. Perizeli span. Push up, press up, pan. Teaching color gat. Wait. Color gat.
Wait.
Teaching color gat.
Wait.
Color gat.
Wait.
Teaching color gat.
Wait.
Color gat.
Wait.
Teaching color gat.
Wait.
Okay, let's do it like this. When they say they making money, they really talking that cap. Niggas say they ballin', they wrestling with the
facts.
When they say they're making money,
yeah,
they're really talking that cat, yabo.
Yeah,
hip hop. I've got a million in the bank. I got a million.
All the time.
Dog, when they say they're making money, this is for everybody. When they say they're making money, they're really talking the cat. Niggas think they're balling. They're wrestling with the facts.
Yeah.
Talking about bitches, they're talking bitches we had.
Yeah.
And we don't buy them no bags. We touch them and send them back. Come on, dog. Drop a bomb. Touch the bitch.
Hey,
Malums.
Yo.
I think right about now, it's that bonus round now.
So what do we do? What do we do with the bonus round now? Because I really wanted to play people just a track from one track from Bloomington EP, but not the whole thing, obviously, like a little snippet. But yeah, before we go there, I'm in between two songs here. I'm between this one.
Oh, we're still going.
Yeah, I'm between this one. Ah!
We're still going, let's go.
But don't cut tequila in binary next and order the magnum. My pigo and Jaeger, sipping the waiter. Sasa benza bana kali for sure. Senta pela baba sabi. Saka zata when no value sugar. Kazo spaga when I'm gonna pull it. I still like it in as rosa bane. Sazo paga uzo bona mape. 30 million. I'm holding a body like my balloon. Selling emojis like my babo. Like my babo. Sipping shampoo.
You know,
it's a movie.
You know what hurts me about like checking all those, like going down memory lane and checking out all those features? I don't have relationships with all those guys I was doing features for. None of them. So it's like,
I heard you say that earlier.
That's what really hurts. And it's like, that's why I gotta charge everybody 90K, even if I like you, man. If you got money in between us, at least I know it was business from the go. You know what I mean?
Man. And I heard you saying that earlier, but you know, before I comment on that, I just wanna give a big shout out to Swiss Beats in the building. Everybody make some noise. Big zone. Mr. Swiss Beats changed the whole world with this. Had hip hop on the internet. Big shout out to Swiss Beats. Swiss Beats actually was like the creator of the shit that we're doing right now. So it's an honor and pleasure to have him in the building, man. Shout out to him and Timberland.
Shout out to Swiss Beats, man.
He's done a lot for South Africa too, coming back and forth, putting artists on Smash in New York and all over the USA and all over the world. So drop a bomb for Swiss Beats. Smee, that thing about, you know, the way I look at it, right, is like, man, we got 10 minutes before they cut us off, so we're going to try to squeeze this last sections into this time. But the way that I look at it for real is like, it's like, you know, sometimes, like most relationships that I don't have with niggas that I should have,
yeah,
I swear it's like, I always look back like, damn, that just needed a conversation. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely, man.
Like, and like, with most cats that I don't get along with, or seemingly don't get along with, or that I don't like, I'm not around every day or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I always feel like most things need a conversation, you know?
Yeah,
and
right.
And the conversation is like, sometimes it's like we hold off having conversations for like years and years. And it's like, because there was never like a natural bond, it always becomes difficult. But like with relationships that I've been able to rekindle in terms of not hanging with people or whatever, but just be like, yo, what happened there? What happened there? Oh, this is what I don't like. This is what I like. I think it's like very, very important as hip hop, we get to the stage where we can have a conversation. You know what I'm saying? And like, I get those feelings, man. I understand all those feelings and I know how it's always worked out, you know? I just hope that like going forward, cats like get honest, like, yo, this is just for the future, let's go. Cause like,
exactly,
you know, like niggas just need to make it like that, and don't make it like we're trying to be best friends or anything. Let's just do the song and get
that. And I think that's why I feel like the feature fee is really important, so everybody knows and everyone is aware with, yo, it's business, you know what I mean? Cause and you're right about the conversation. It's like, who's going to be the bigger man? Who's going to go, yo, remember what you promised? Like, you know, actually, or all of that stuff. But yeah, man, I'm not really torn up. It's just, I hate the fact that I don't have those relationships anymore. That's what I hate. Like, the song is out and everything, and the crowds are going, yo, that's the best song you guys ever did. Like, why aren't you making more music? And it's like, we don't have a relationship because like, somebody
said, of that situation, like, really never worked out. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So, and this is a sport, really, man. Like, so if you want to feature me on a song, I'm definitely going to give you 150 or 200%. So never expect me to do less. And if people are saying, yo, my verse is crazy, that's what it is. And it made your song really go like to its full potential. And obviously the streams are going to come for the both of us. Do you get what I'm saying? So I don't know whether, but yeah, before we go off, I need to
play one more. I got to play one more. Since we're talking about features, this one got me in a lot of trouble. Shout out to my OG Stogie T. I love you. I will always love you, but I got to play this one. I'll take it back. Big shout out to Casper on your vest.
Why you niggas ask so many questions? Last day, motherfuckers ain't like me. What happened to Riky?
Hey, people want to know what happened to Riky. The same thing that happened to 50. Ever since that shit dropped, they've been asking me, what happened to 50, actually? But we'll leave it to them. We'll leave it to them to answer that one. I don't know myself.
It's an open plan situation.
Hey, Smee. This has been crazy, dog. I'm just trying to regulate here because we can't go back on for one more song. We got 7 minutes left.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Let's wrap it up. It's been beautiful.
Okay, so do you guys want to see the last song or do you want the snippet from Bloomington? What are you saying?
Snippet. Play the snippet.
The snippet?
Okay, we want to hear. The EP's coming. We know the EP's coming. Nah, don't die out right now. Don't die out, bro. Damn. It died. Hey, but listen, man, I just want to give a big shout out to everybody who tuned in. Big shout out to Gemini and Tweezy for getting us to do this. It's big for the culture. A big shout out to Swiss Beats and Timbaland for starting this trend all over the world. Bringing music together. I literally have like, probably, I don't know how long, but I don't know. Is it 5 minutes? Yeah, it's about 5 minutes left because it's about to get to 12 right now. So I just want to give a big shout out to everybody who tuned in, man. One love. Smee is a motherfucking killer. It's an honor and a privilege to be on this platform with him. He's my bigger brother. Oh, here we got him. We got him back. So it's been an honor and a privilege, man, to be part of this, man. Crazy. Malum is back. Now we got 4 minutes. Back. Now we got 4 minutes. Let's go.
Okay. I'm just going to play this track.
New music.
Ooh, yeah,
I took a nap on a red eye.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
Boba will fly like an airline.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
My money all in the spin eye.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
I can go rumble like GI.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
I took a nap on a red eye.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
Boba will fly like an airline.
Ooh, yeah, shoo.
My money only the
sin I have. Ooh, yeah,
I can go rumble like G.I. Coming and smoking them trees. Then call out my G. Then call out my G. Shambok, I came with the heat.
I'm very legit. I'm cutting like Jada Magic. Come with the thing in my Jeep. Come with the vibe and you will be my Jeep. I be the Alpha Omega the Z. When I dress up, I just think magazine. Talk about my diet, I love my physique. Came in the game and you playing for keeps. Got me an office, I'm still on the streets. Inside the deli, I'm off in the street. Came with the bookings, so still no receipts. I'm probably spending an hour in them sheets. Living the shit on repeat every week.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
I took a nap on the red eye.
Ooh, yeah, sure. Yeah,
sure. We fly like an airline.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
My money only the senile.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
I can go rumble like G.I.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
Sure.
I took a nap on a red eye.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
That's what we're talking about.
I feel like an airline.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
My money only the senile.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
I can go rumble like G.I.s.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
Captain it, me in the Vic where the section is. Popping the shampoo, we celebrate.
Ooh, yeah, sure.
A lot of hate. All of the stalkers that imitate.
Everybody make sure,
yeah,
when they let you know what date this is coming out, make sure you put a time in the morning that you're going to wake up. You write the name of the album in your calendar and you make sure you wake up and get that Bloomington EP coming soon. Okmalumkoolkat is back with another one, and you never left.
Mid-May, we're going to drop the EP mid-May. The album is ready. It's coming after the lockdown, like third quarter. So shout out to everybody supporting. Shout out to everybody that checked it out, like checked out this live. Shout out to you, Riky. Shout out to Tweezy. Shout out to Gemini Major.
One more. As we take it out, we love you guys so much, man. Big up to everyone. It's probably just going to cut us anyway. But a big shout out to Malooms, man. Thank you so much, bro. Like, dog.
Much love.
Much love, bro.
Shortcut.
Let's play one more, though. Let's go.
Your whole clip.
Hey. We got to get our collaboration mixtape on.
Yeah, we do.
The anthems would be crazy.
It's long overdue, bro.
Play the one with D Koala's verse. Maybe it's a good thing I did it. D Koala killed this beat. Killed it.
So that track is not out yet.
Nah, it's not out. We've been trying to take it out, but like, I don't know. You know, shit takes time.
Yeah, man. Before we go, I'm ready for you. If you want to do that, if you want to do that, like that collab project, I'm ready, bro.
Man, it would be beautiful, man.
I'm ready.
It would be beautiful. Man, I've let's keep the line open, man. It's a pleasure.
Obviously, we got the EP out now. The album, Mushuga the Dean, is coming. I think after that, I'm down to actually do, like, even if we do, like, a four-track, a six-track thing, but back-to-back. You know, like, how Future and Drake are doing?
Yeah.
Why not? Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
Awe. Sharp.
Ladies, thank you so much for tuning in. We love you guys. Keep the culture going. Next week, they're going to be back doing it again. But thank you to Okmalumkoolkat. Thank you, Gemini, Tweezy, everybody who was in the chat, everyone involved. It's been a beautiful thing. One love. We love you guys very much. It's me.
Shout out, bro.
Broadcast live.